How do you decide whether your reflections are horizontal or vertical straight?
They're usually both, but they'll break through. They'll break through, like here is breaking through. You can stop them wherever you want. So, like if I want to stop that thing, I can just take this colored value and go across it. Slow your eye down. And then even pick it up again if you want to. But the whole thing now is just a matter of putting more varieties to things. For instance, I might want to add a little more variety to this mountain. So I got to get to the value first again. So now I'm mixing paint and I'm going for the value still. Putting a little red in it, a little more pigment in spots. Kind of following the form of the mountain in spots. There's a little bit of blue in it as well that I didn't really get in the first round, so I'm going to put some of that in there. It's just a hair darker.
This is what is so amazing to me about your paintings, of the mountains and hills, how much range and variety there is of color and shape.
And I think that, you know, what I love painting that stuff because it's so hard. It's just so much stuff, you know. And the challenge of it is just immense. So now I'm going to increase the cool there just a little bit. A spot or two. Let's say there's a piece of light on that mountain back there. I got to watch that it doesn't come forward. So let's say I look at it and I see this really bright color right there. That's not bad. It seems to sit in there still. There'll be some that'll go across that mass a little bit more. There's some that'll go sneak over here. It might be one over there. You know, you're just trying to figure out how to put them in too. So just watch and don't try to put them all in. You see them. I think there's also some cools that could go up underneath these trees right here. Just a little cooler, a little more weight. So this value is the same as that one now, and I'm going just a little bluer underneath the trees. And that makes that other look warmer. Because you can see how cool it is back in there still. And it's even more when you see it in person, and you turn upside down, you really see it.
What size demo are you doing on Saturday?
I don't know what I'm doing. I think it's going to be somewhere in the 24 by 30 range. Or somewhere. I can't remember what I brought with me. So now these marks that I'm putting in are just different. I'm trying to find different ways of putting some of this light in. Some of the softer edge, some of the harder edge. Some of those trees will break down through here more. So we were talking about ruby violet. Let's say I want to put some cooler colors and values back in this, in these trees here. So I put a little ruby violet in there. Just maybe one mark or two. It doesn't have to be a lot. It can be a little. It can be a really cool. But again, it's what the painting will bear. I don't know yet. So if I put that in, And if I think it's too strong, I can just touch it again, it'll merge. If not, I can do that and put a green right inside that, and that'll soften it too. So it's like, you know, there's more than one way to do this. I'm going to go a little, I think I need to introduce red in this painting a little more. I'm just talking out loud because I want you guys to...
That helps. Mm-hmm. Keep talking.
So, because I think I just, out of everything, I don't want to paint on the blue and yellow side, so I'm going to get a little more violet in here as well as in the pine trees. So those don't just look completely green yet. You'll see green in it, you'll see violet in it, you'll see everything. So those trees in the distance, there's another place I could put some cooler reds. So I'm going to take some reds into the distance here so that this painting doesn't seem all yellow and pretty. So those reds, they'll stand back there. They'll stay back there then. So I'm painting a group of trees, not just a individual pine trees back there yet. So this is more about the grouping being different. So some of the tops you'll see, some of them will just merge with one another. Again, the little ticks are kind of important in spots too, so you can get a bit of a dark in there when you need it. I'm getting really sloppy, but you clean it up later. So this is where I start playing with the warms, cool, still. I mean, I still will start doing that. I won't allow it to just, you know, this is the part we always try to fix things, and you kind of need to just go back and forth, so just wet, warm, cool, warm, cool. So I'm going to just show you the kind of playing I'll do with this now, because this is a study to me. I'll look out there and I'll say, well, there's a little oranger in there. You see how much more reflected light I can get in there and go toward a yellowish tone. For the middle. So that's pretty bright. So I'm going to knock it down just a little bit more. And that's having a hard time reading its shadow right now. But I pressed that, and I know I just did. But it looks like it's still kind of working. If not, if I put just a little more weight in around it in a couple spots, that'll do it too. Or I can go redder, put a red in there. So all I'm doing is just playing with this thing and trying to understand where I can go within that shadow and get a different color here. So these are all those ticks we're talking about, those lights and darks. So you could have a branch that I wouldn't want to put it in because it's too... it'll be too centered. But you can have some of the trees will have darks in them. They'll have some of these trunks in there. But I don't want them too sharp. So I'll probably put it in different ways. I'll try it with a brush, and then I'll try it with a palette knife. That's too harsh. I need a finer brush. But if I had a couple of darks in there, just got to watch the edges of them still. The light of the trees. Value range somewhere. So this is the kind of playing I like doing with them. Even though it's got some structure, there's all kinds of improvements that can be made in it. And it's just kind of playing. So now I'm gonna darken the sky a little. Not that I think it needs it. I just am doing it to screw with you. So if you do it.
And when you're doing your blues, how do you choose whether to use the cobalt or the ultramarine?
Who said that? I can use either one. Ultramarine's got more red in it. I'm using the cobalt for you guys so you can see the key. You can see there's plenty of darks still. That's what I want you to see. So I have not touched much of that. If I did, I did a little bit in some of the pine trees, but I didn't need it.
So if you want a darker blue, you'd use the ultramarine or blue?
I can, but this cobalt is plenty dark.
Yeah.
It's a really dark color.
But it's warmer.
It's warmer than,
yeah,
this has got more red in it. Yeah. So if you do one of those things, or you get, this is when people start panicking, right? So you go, well, that color's brighter, and it's going to have everything out there. So you can put, so that's really yellow. Can the painting bear that? I don't know. It's got more of a chance because the neutral underneath. But let's say I touch it again. Or let's say I take that other orange that I have mixed and just put it right on top of it. Now it's kind of sitting in there and it's a little bit better. But you can't handle too many of those things in a painting. I might go redder. In there, maybe go yellow first, then go redder. It'll really push your eye back.
So if your values are decreasing in the distance, okay, and merging, so that means your warms in the distance are cooling and your cools in the distance are warming. Is that right?
I just put a combination in. I just keep working with warm and cools within each one. So let's say I want to...
As long as the value is right.
Yeah,
right?
As long as the value is right. So let's say I want to change the color of the sky a little more. And I want to just get some vibrating light in there. So let me just mess with you a little here. So let's take some red. This is just red and white. I gotta get rid of that value, though, see? It's in the way. So there's red and white in this color right here, and that's it. Then I'm gonna go green and white. That'll scare you. Because it'll be, whoops, I got a little phthalo in there. And I've got a little phthalo. It's green and white. Let's see how those pieces are still modified because they're not, I'm not thoroughly mixing them. And it's fine.
Yeah. Would you throw yellow and white in there too? Just to
match it? Yeah, you can, yeah. But I have some here too. So.
What did she put in that bottle she brought in?
Oh.
Yeah. Hello and white. Oh, there's that's a dandy. That'll scare you.
Start a little bang up.
So yeah. not too saturated back in there, but but the value is kind of, I'm moving the value a little too far. So, but now I can go back in it and still start adding some blue to it. And I can go with the blue and green and blue and whatever I'm doing. And go back in it again.
Doing that, your brush strokes are all going down.
If you go across, it'll read different. Uh-huh. The paint, the light hits it different.
The light's different.
Yeah. When I go across this plane, it stands up a little more.
You want it to, right.
That's if I go down, it'll merge more.
Right.
Not a best way, but like in here, I want this to come down, and then I want that to go across there. Now I'm going to try to merge this a little bit more. I'm going to change the color, just see if I can, so you guys can see it happen. I'm going to make a greener color right in here. So it transitions into a greener color and then a bluer color.
Did you put phthalo on it?
I think I did.
Mm-hmm. That makes the water feel deeper, doesn't it?
Yeah, it kind of does. A little more depth to it, but reflect that bush a little bit, maybe reflect these trees back here a little. Cloud. You can put some of those on the water in here too. You can go crazy with that if you want, but just enough where you feel like there's a reflective.
You could put a sailboat in there.
You could. You could do that.
Maybe a kayak.
We'll all know it's an accident, but we. So let's say I want
to.
So this is the kind of thing Sergeant would do. He'd take a. If he wanted to put an accent once in a while, he'd put a value in here like this first. Kind of merge it, soften it, and then you put a light inside that. So it doesn't look so quite so abrupt. You just do all kinds of different things with it. And so it's not a right and wrong, it's just learn to do that stuff and try it. I don't want this, I think the sky's a little abrupt in spots too, so I'm going to merge this just a little bit more. How are you doing there? have to go to lunch somebody. All right. So all those marks I made in the sky, kind of like, where did they go?
Yep.
So you can do anything with values. I don't like that dark in there, but that's all right.
Dark in where?